Factsverse presents. This is the U.S. Navy's most decorated ship, and there's a good reason why you've never heard of it. First, help us spread the word about Factsverse by clicking that like button. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. In June 1968, the United States Navy ordered a special submarine to be built. When it was completed, it was christened the USS Parche, SSN 683, and it was launched in January 1973. While it was launched in 1973 for the first time, it wasn't until 18 months later that it was used for active service in the Navy, and from then on, the ship was invaluable. Throughout the three decades that the USS Parche was involved in naval operations, it is said that it never fired its weapon even once. Even though the weapons were never used, it was essential in protecting the interests of America. Even after the Cold War, it was still essential. In October 2004, the vessel had served its time in the Navy and was retired from active service. 9 months after being retired, its name was taken off the register of American vessels in the Navy. By the time it was retired, it was one of the highest decorated vessels in the United States naval history. You probably just don't know about it. Over the years, naval ships in the United States changed a lot. Over the years, the U.S. learned a lot about the strengths and weaknesses of ships, and during each war, they learned more and more about what was working and what wasn't. In the early 60s, the United States Navy began building Sturgeon-class submarines. This new generation of ship was nuclear-powered. The primary job was to attack the enemy ships. The first of its kind was entered into service in 1967. These submarines could reach a maximum speed of 26 knots, which is just under 30 miles per hour. The subs were armed with Harpoon and Tomahawk missiles. The subs were also designed with torpedo tubes in the middle of each vessel. During the Cold War, there were a number of Sturgeon-class ships. The USS Sturgeon, the USS Tautug, and the USS Pargo, just to name a few. There was one ship in particular that earned more honors than most for its service, and that was the USS Parche. The USS Parche first launched in 1973. It got its name from a butterfly fish that's often found around coral reefs. Each ship christened was given a sponsor who was often a woman of society, and this was said to provide the vessel with good luck. The sponsor for the USS Parche was Mrs. Philip A. Bechany. Richard and Charles originally commanded the vessel, and it was part of America's Atlantic Fleet Submarine Force up until 1976. In October of that year, it was reassigned to the Pacific Fleet. When the USS Parche joined the Pacific Fleet, it underwent some altercations. Around the same time, the ship disappeared from public view. That's because it was chosen to be part of the National Underwater Reconnaissance Office. The National Underwater Reconnaissance Office, or NURO, began operation in 1969 so that the CIA and the U.S. Navy could oversee the underwater surveillance. And that was a very secretive branch. Nobody knew that it existed until 1998. Along with the USS Parche, the other ships involved were the USS Seawolf and the USS Halibut. They were there to spy on the Soviets. The ships were outfitted with instruments that allowed them to listen in on enemy communications, and that was essential in collecting important information. When the U.S. found a communication cable in the Soviet-controlled Sea of Okhotsk, they saw an opportunity. It was a great way to listen in on everything the Soviet Navy was doing. When the USS Parche completed its mission in the Sea of Okhotsk, it moved on to other secret missions. Between 1987 and 1991, the USS Parche was out of commission while modifications were performed. This time, they extended the vessel by about 100 feet at the hull, and that made room for more members and equipment to fit on board. It also allowed the ship to sit at the bottom of a seabed. Finally, in 2004, after 30 years of service, the ship was retired. It's the U.S. Navy's most decorated ship, and you probably never heard of it. All of its missions were secret and classified. The ship was involved in hundreds of missions, but we don't know about most of them. Part of having a successful military is keeping secrets from the enemy, and the only way to keep secrets from the enemy is to keep the missions secret from everybody. Only members of the military with the highest security clearance are able to hear about the secret missions of these vessels. Subscribe for more!